turning.
Body.
One and two and down. Up, down.
Nice.
Two. Try and keep in the diagonal in Ace and Tim. Stop. All right, good. Okay. Thank you, Victoria. Okay, Nancy, sorry about your... Okay, guys, let's just go back to the beginning and make sure that we're going to the correct spacing and all the rest of it. And be careful that we don't... We talked about music a lot yesterday. Be careful we don't race the music. Stay right in the middle of it. So let's do one more time, just the very beginning. Don't forget the arms in the arabesque here. I'm still seeing it up here. Arms really down, and as Kevin keeps saying, two, hold that leg. One, two,
You don't have to do it as the silence of the movement is active, but not stiff. It's still a movement. It's not rigid.
Yeah.
It's one, hold two, one, hold two. Keep it elegant and quiet and clear.
Yeah.
Sweethearts, there's one place, Judy, where they do penché. Make sure that you round your arms behind under your bustle.
Yes, it goes all the way behind. Yeah. So you're actually meeting behind here.
And the other place that might, after the pirouette, you do pirouette into forward. Don't do it to us, do it for you, not for us. It's pirouette, not finish for us, finish for you. Yeah.
Yeah. That was much better. This makes a big difference to those feet. And ladies, the port de bras is much better. Just make sure you're looking across. We're going to go from the beginning and do this once through to here. But when you get to the crossing, as you get to the back, start marking it. Do the arms full out, but don't try and do it properly. And then we'll finish with this. Yeah? From the top? From the running on? So, Victoria, we'll just go into the mise-en-scène and then we'll stop. Okay, so guys, make the first change so you walk out a little bit at the end of it. All right, now I leave it up to you. You look each other across, make sure you're evenly spaced. Don't go ahead, Tim, careful. Just forget. Elegant. Stop. Let's go from here. On my hands, Victoria. You ready, guys? Forward a fraction, Daniel. Yeah, that's it. And then Daniel, that's it. And. Hold. Yeah, not too soon. Down. Low arms, better. And hold. Two. Down, up. Something wrong here. I think these guys are too far out. And down, up, down. And leg and arm, up, hold, deep, better. Tim, you travel a bit more forward next time. And four, five, six. Oh, guys.
Nice.
You said something about a head on that arabesque?
Okay. They did it.
Yeah.
It's another moment.
Okay.
Dave, good.
Nice, guys. All the way down, ladies. Head as well. Good. Fifth. indulge. Up, feet, feet. Up, feet, feet. Okay, be careful. Go downstage, Joey. That's it.
Make room, cross, good.
Yeah. I said... Three and four. Five, six, one,
hold two, two,
step and cross.
Four.
In line, step and cross. Too late, Hannah. Up. D, D, D. Just move out.
Marguerite.
Upstage. Okay, thank you very much. All right, guys. Very good. We continue on tomorrow. Very good. I'll see you later. Thank you,
thank
guys.
You.
Thank you, Golden Ball.
There's one place that I keep forgetting to say. It's in the perfume section. They do this, they do this, they do this, they do the pancher. What do they do just after the pancher?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Dutch National Ballet in Amsterdam. My name is Wendeline Wijkstra, and on behalf of all of the dancers, I'd love to say hi to our friends all over the world. You just watched The Golden Ball from the ballet La Dame aux Camélias by John Neumeier, and you might know this story as La Traviata from Verdi. Our company has been working on this choreography for a couple of weeks now, and I have to say it's really wonderful to dance. It has beautiful details, a very profound storyline, and the choreography is very challenging. For more information, please check our website operaballet.nl. We'll be showing you two pas de deux, the white and the black one, danced by Igor Nedejung together with Daniel Camargo and Anna Tsigankova with James Stout. And before we go on, I'd like to introduce you to our artistic director, Ted Bransen. Hello, Ted. Thank you very much for your time. We have done La Dame aux Camélias a few years ago, and I remember it was a beautiful experience for everyone. So I can imagine your answer, but could you explain to us why you wanted to bring it back again so soon?
We bring it back 3 years after the premiere because it was a huge success for the company and for the audience. And so many people wanted to see it, and that's why we're bringing it back again. It's a beautiful, beautiful ballet and one of my favorite works. And I'm very happy that John Neumeier is coming himself to work with us next week. And it's great to have Kevin Hagen here to work with the principals. So I think our staff is doing a really good job at bringing it back.
Fantastic. Thank you very much for your
you.
Time. We will soon be going on to some dancing. As I said to you, we'll show the white and the black pas de deux. We'll be starting with the white one, danced by Igor Nedejung and Daniel Camargo. The rehearsal will be led by Rachel Beaujean, who is our deputy artistic director, together with Kevin Hagen, who Ted has already kindly introduced, and he's the deputy director of the Hamburg Ballet, as well as the right hand of John Neumeier. This pas de deux always touches all of us very much, so I hope you will love it as much as I do. Enjoy.
Intimate. It's for you. It's not for us. It's private. We're allowed to watch you. It's private. Don't move. Beautiful. E. Don't dance. Beautiful, dance. Don't move. Don't dance. Go. You swiftly and stop dancing, look at each other. Get in front of her, Danny. There we go. Private. Don't move. Really don't move. Go. Use your legs. Oh, the dynamics, yes. Quick. Swift. And whisper. Private, don't move. It's for you. Yes. Stop dancing, even if you're late, stop. Protector. Good, coming.
Yeah. You wanted to do that thing as she handles.
Ah, yes,
before,
you know.
Before the lift back.
You know when we do, the lift is coming very well. After the ting into the knee, under the dress, reach. Make sure we don't turn it. We have to turn it, but not too much. We need to see her head move now. If she could go over your shoulder, release your arms into third position, but without being too orthodox with it. Uh-huh. That you go into a version of third position over his back. And now, catch me under the arm. Yeah, good boy. And girl. Try. That was very good. It's coming, Danny.
Should we do the whole lift?
I'm not sure. We're very easy to get into. Good boy. All right. Now, make sure that she can, yes. Now, take her under the pit. Let her release her head. Good boy. Run. Lift the back knee if you can. Good girl. Now from there, hair. Release. Good. Now I want to see your face. Put it on your shoulder so we see your face. Come around backwards and run forward. Yeah. Good. Danny, it's excellent. You just threw away the really nice moment. It was the hard part you did. The easy part. Run her forward into the yin and yang, into the small yin and yang, the circles. You don't have to hold them rigidly, but we always, even when we walk and we go through, it's complete. It's like a half a circle, and a complete is perfection. A circle is perfection. So together, you're perfect, and you just exist together. So you don't make the circle, you are the circle. Mm-hmm. So when you go, he's half and you're half, and then she steps. And if you do it too rigid, it becomes like, but it's subconscious that you show it. Thank you, Olga. Thank you. It's excellent.
Before I go on, I would love to ask you some questions.
Sure.
That was beautiful. Every time I watch it, I can't help but being so moved. Igor, you also danced this 3 years ago.
Yes.
And I remember it was very special for you to dance the role of Marguerite. How does it feel this time? Can you explain to us what this ballet means to you?
Well, I think it's the most important big role of my career. Last time I danced it with another partner, so this time I'm reliving the story with someone else, which is really nice, very different, but very nice. Working with Kevin is one of the best experiences of my career, so I'm really happy he's back.
to relive it with me. So it's like I'm living the dream.
That sounds fantastic. Thank you, Hugo. Daniel, it's the first time you're dancing in this ballet. Could you tell us how it's going? How are you feeling?
It's really, really nice to be doing, and especially with Igor, that has done so many times. And having Kevin also in the team now is really nice, and to be able to learn his production, and we'll see how it goes.
It feels like we're in a bubble, and it's a really nice bubble.
Great. Thank you so much for your time, and good luck with the rehearsals. Before we go on, I would love to ask Rachel and Kevin here to see if we can hear some more about the ballet, please. Rachel, you've spent a lot of time with the principals in the studio. This season we're going to do big classical ballets. We are bringing back Cinderella, Swan Lake,
and we're also going to be doing your Giselle right after La Dame. But these ballets all have a very profound storyline. Could you tell us how you approach the rehearsals with all these emotions?
And I think it's important for all ballets, not only the story ballets, but we're people and we want to communicate something to the audience, and it's no use just making pretty pictures. And this ballet reminds us of that, and that's why it's touching us very much. And then we have Kevin now to be coaching us and really going into the depth of how to act as a dancer. And it's almost like method acting, and it's very, we go through many layers together, and it's very confronting for the dancers, because you have to show something of yourself and you have to not hide behind any facade.
I think what Rachel said is so important, that we're people dancing. We're not objects moving. And even if it's only a ballet that is about the music and steps and dance, which is also very valid as choreography, it's still a human person executing the movements. And for this generation in time, especially, that we can't only become digitalized, that we also have to keep something from our true emotions, our human side, because that's what we can touch people with. Not only amaze the eye, but perhaps even touch something very inside to the public that isn't sensational, but maybe. I remember Eric Broom was my teacher, and he used to say, you know, it's hard enough to try to be good. No one needs to be great. And that's what I think John does. So that's how we work with John. Yeah. There's never an empty step. Mm-hmm. Every step in every ballet from John is inspired from an emotion. And when you watch him, what's interesting to watch him create is that he's trying to invent. Actually, I'm always impressed that he's trying to go farther than the vocabulary we know, and invent a step from an emotion.
It's so wonderful to hear you say all of these things, because even as dancers, it's exactly how we feel. We feel no disconnection from who we are and being on the stage, but we feel the same person within the character that we're
perhaps
doing, which
you
is
know
fantastic.
Also why? I believe because this company was born from a choreographer, and I truly believe in that.
Yeah. Thank you both so much for your time and your wonderful answers. So after these wonderful stories from the ballet masters, we're going to go on. We're going to go to the Black Pas de Deux, danced by Anna Tsigankova and James Stout. And we're all very thrilled because Anna just became a mom. She had a baby. And last year, James was promoted to principal dancer. And they very much love dancing this Black Pas de Deux. So please enjoy.
Thank you.
Good girl. Beautiful. It's so nice to see this development. Beautiful. Wow.
Mm. It's wonderful, the back leg. Mm. It's like they're sinking.
In every direction. Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Becomes so open. Good girl. Oh. Clever. More to the corner.
Just so that they can travel this step. Thank you.
Yes. Beautiful. She does the wrong leg on that one, but it suits her, so I'm going to go with the flow. Mm-hmm. The third one should be the right leg front from the beginning.
Like always the same leg in the front.
Yeah. So it starts squawking, goes around, but it leave it. It's.
But maybe it'll help her.
Maybe.
Also, she should be now.
She's active.
Him.
Yes, she's the active one. Get down to her so she can take you. All right. That worked.
Nice.
Good boy. Body front. Whack. Almost body on top of leg. Good boy. Body on top of leg. Yes. Good. Very good.
Forgot to kiss.
Five, six, four, one, six for nothing. One. Four. She heard it, good girl. Well done.
Yeah.
Well done.
Beautiful.
Lovely.
What do you mean by the kiss at the end?
This is picky. It was very, very good. I believe what you're doing. When she's kissing you passionately at the end, don't reject her so adamantly. You know, it's not a rejection. It's a, you're still passionate when you get on your knees and you ask her, can I trust you? And by rejecting her, how you did it, I did believe you, but I wouldn't do that. But I find it very good, and it's beautiful. Thank you. There's one thing that also we do. One leg is a little not exact right. That you go up in. Thank you. This change you did. Now this leg, Anna, should go this forward before. Is it James? Then we go up in. Now the last one, I should turn you this way. Yes, and that's right, and then close you. Right, perfect. Yeah. You're right, it's nicer for her. Yeah, it's you go up in, turn back on the third one. You'll like it. It takes the swing away and it's more poetic. Whoa. Yeah, a little less. See, you're so used to you need so much swing. You need less. You'll need much less swing now. Yeah, yeah.
And while you're here, Anna, I don't know. It looks uncomfortable. She's gone away. She, you know, after the rolling around on the floor, and then you get up, and this penché.
I'm touching his back.
Couldn't she do? Do we have the right arm? I was wondering.
I've gone through different periods with different arms. I believe the last time around it could have been fourth or best, not third, which would make it the other arm.
Somehow it looks like you can't move there.
Okay. Oh, wow.
That's it. Oh, that looks so much better.
But it is better. It's just for the boy, it's
harder.
Yeah, it is. You'll get it. You'll do it. Sometimes it manages and sometimes not, but think we should.
Yeah.
Good. It's very
Thanks,
good.
Guys.
Very
Beautiful.
Good. Excellent, excellent.
What can I say? That's
incredible. I'm so happy to watch you both again dancing this ballet. And thank you, Kevin and Rachel, very much as well. Thank you. Anna, you've danced this ballet before together with James. But like we said before, you had a son, you're a mom now. Do you approach the character of Marguerite differently now?
Well, they say motherhood changes everything, and it's indeed so. I'm very grateful for this chance to experience love on such a profound level, as the mother can feel love for her child. And I feel like definitely I can add so many more colors to this role now, because that story is also about love. So different faces of love, but it's still love. So I do feel really, really great dancing this role with James second time around. It feels so, so calm in a way, and so like well-oiled mechanism, you know, so that we don't actually think about mechanics anymore because we build on it. And yeah, I feel like total penetration. So we read it off each other so easily now. So that makes me feel that everything is created right here on the spot. So that's beautiful. And that the only like ballerina can dream of. That's such a great partner.
So nice of you to say. And I understand what you're saying, because the connection between the two of you makes such sense. It's like you're one together. It's really beautiful to watch. But James, last time you danced this role, it was the first time you ever did it. So now I can imagine it feels also differently for you, because you started from a different point. Could you tell us about how that feels now?
Yeah, sorry, I'm still catching my breath. I mean, it's amazing how much the body remembers. And so even 3 years later, it comes back so quickly, and we don't have to relearn things, and we are able to dive much more into like our characters and the connection and the partnership, rather than trying to spend all that extra energy on also learning the steps. So for us, I think it's just a much more
depth,
I just depth feel and like we are color.
Both, yeah, much more experienced than 3 years ago, because many things happened to our lives, and you know, each of us, I feel like we brought it into the characters, you know, into the studio, and
you take all the experience you've gained over that gap in time and build on it, so we can go much further now, and it feels great.
It looks great. Thank you both so much, and all the luck in the world to you both. Thank you all so much for watching. That's already the end of our World Ballet Day. Of course, we hope very much that you enjoyed watching us today. This was La Dame aux Camélias with the Dutch National Ballet. And now I'm so inspired by what we just watched. I would love to say to you all to realize how important it is to create beauty in your life in whatever way it is. Like Anna said, life is about love. We wish you all a wonderful World Ballet Day for the rest of it. We'll all be following you, of course. And please don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram. And what else do we have? On our YouTube channel, of course. And for now, we would love to show you the trailer of this ballet. And thank you again for watching, and we hope to see you here soon. Bye.